morning students, welcome back to saradamaths channel, and this is the continuation video of the eamcet coaching classes matrices video number 3. Okay, let us start the problem. So the first question: if A is equal to lambda mu mu square minus lambda square minus lambda mu, then A is equals to, what is A matrix here, what type of matrix here A is? Okay, the options are idempotent matrix, nilpotent matrix, orthogonal matrix and symmetric matrix. Okay, already I explained all these definitions in the previous video. So anybody want to know the definitions, then watch the video number 2, matrices class 2. Okay, so what is the meaning of the idempotent matrix? What is the meaning here? The condition is A square is equals to E. Okay, and what is the meaning of the nilpotent matrix? A power n is equal to 0. And what is the meaning of the orthogonal matrix? A into A transpose is equals to I. And what is the meaning of the skew symmetric matrix? A transpose is equals to K. Okay, so these are the definitions here. So first I am finding the value of the A square here. Okay, so once check first here, I am checking the first option. If it is not satisfied, then I will check the second one. If this is also not satisfied, and then I will check the third one. After that, fourth one. That is, here I am checking the options one by one to get the required answer. Okay, so that is the processor. Okay, so first here I am finding the value, A square value. So A square is equal to lambda mu mu square minus lambda square minus lambda mu into lambda mu mu square minus lambda square minus lambda mu. Okay, so multiplying the two matrices here, so this is equals to first row by the first column. So first element, lambda mu into lambda mu is equal to lambda square mu square plus mu square into minus lambda square, that is mu square lambda square minus. Next one, first row by the second column, lambda into mu cube minus lambda into mu cube. Now second row by the first column, that is minus lambda cube into mu, minus of minus plus lambda cube into mu. And last one, second row by the second column, that is minus lambda square mu square, minus of minus plus lambda square mu square. Okay, now see here, all the terms are cancelled here, therefore the answer is equal to 0. Okay, therefore A square is equal to 0 means we get the answer like that, A power n is equal to 0, and here the value of the n is equal to 2. Therefore the matrix A is the nilpotent matrix. Okay, so this is nothing but the nilpotent matrix. Nilpotent matrix means A power n is equal to 0. So here we get the value A square is equal to 0, therefore the matrix A is the nilpotent matrix, and that is the second option. Understand all of you? So here we get the value, this one is equal to 0, so directly you can say that the answer is the second option. Okay, see the next one. If A is equal to this matrix, then what is A matrix? Here also some options are given here. Types of the matrices: this is Hermitian, this is skew Hermitian, this is symmetric, this is skew symmetric. Okay, see here, what is the meaning of the Hermitian? A bar is equals to A transpose. If A bar is equal to A transpose, then this is said to be the Hermitian. And what is the meaning of the skew Hermitian? A bar is equal to minus A transpose. And what is the meaning of the symmetric? A is equal to A transpose. And what is the meaning of the skew symmetric? A transpose is equal to minus E. Okay, so these are the definitions of these four matrices. So first we are checking the options one by one. So first I am taking the value A bar. A bar is nothing but the conjugate matrix. What is the meaning of the conjugate matrix? We have to replace each and every element of this matrix by its conjugate number. That is, I am replacing all these elements by with its conjugates. That is, what is the conjugate of the 1? That is equals to 1. In this value, there is no complex number, there is no imaginary part. This is not the complex number. So directly we take that this value is equals to 1. And what is 2 minus 3i conjugate? 2 plus 3i. And what is 3 plus 4i conjugate? 3 minus 4i. Similarly, coming to the second row, 2 minus 3i, 0, 4 plus 5i. And coming to the third row, 3 plus 4i, 4 minus 5i, 2. Okay, so this is the conjugate matrix. So this is the answer of the conjugate. Now I am finding the A transpose also. What is the meaning of the A transpose? Simply changing the rows as the columns. Now I am writing the first row as the first column. Okay, I am taking the first row as the first column. So this becomes 1, 2 minus 3, I 3 plus 4, I, that is the first column. And taking the second row as the second column, 2 plus 3, I 0, 4 minus 5, I. And taking the third row as the third column, that is 3 minus 4, I, 4 plus 5, I, 2, I. Now check the two matrices here. Now, this is A bar answer, this is A transpose. See here, the two matrices are equal here. Therefore, A bar is equal to A transpose, therefore the matrix A is the Hermitian matrix. So this is the definition of the Hermitian. A bar is equal to A transpose. So answer is the first option. Okay, that's all. That is the answer. Okay, see the next problem. If A is equal to Aij, this is the matrix with order is equals to n by n, is an upper triangular matrix, then Aij is equals to, where I greater than C, that is we have to find all these elements, Aij elements. What is the condition given here between I and J? I greater than C. Okay, so what is given here? One matrix is given. So first I am writing the matrix Aij. Aij means this is the matrix that contains the n rows and n columns. Okay, so this is the matrix that contains the n rows and n columns. What is given here? What is the given question? This is the upper triangular matrix. Upper triangle, suppose here I am taking the diagonal elements A11, A22, A33 and so on, so on, ANN. These are the elements of the diagonal. Upper triangular means the elements below the diagonal are equal to 0. That is, this is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 and so on, so on. These are all also 0, 0, 0. These all elements are equal to 0, 0, 0. Okay. Now here, and what is the element here we have? This is A12, this is A13 and so on, so on, A1n. And this is A23 and so on, so on, A2n. Okay. And this is A34 and so on, so on, A3n. Okay. What is the given question? We want the elements Aij. For I greater than j, that is we have to find the values A21, A31, A41 and so on, so on, A32, A43, like that. We have to find all these elements. That is, what is this? This is second row first element A21. Third row first element A31, fourth row first element. Okay, that is, these are okay. Once check all these numbers here, what is the relation between these two numbers here? This here, the relation is I less than J. First value is less than the second one. Okay, but here in all these elements, we have that first element is greater than the second one, A21, A31, A41. That is, here all the elements are equal to 0, Aij. For I greater than J, okay, if I greater than J, then all the values, the elements below the diagonal are all equal to 0. And to all these elements here, what is the condition? I greater than J. So here answer is equal to 0 and that is the last option. Okay, so this is answer. Okay, see the next question. If A is equal to Aij is a scalar matrix of order n by n such that Aij is equal to k, for all I is equal to j, then what is the trace of the matrix A? Okay, see here, one matrix is given here Aij. So this is given that this is the scalar matrix of order n by n. That is, this is the matrix that contains n rows and n columns. Order is equal to n by n. And also given that Aij value is equal to k for I is equal to j. That is, Aij is equal to k for I is equal to j means, here I am taking that I is equal to j, that is A11 is equal to k, A22 is equal to k, A33 is equal to k and so on, so on, ANN is equal to k. So this is the given condition here, the value of the Aij is equal to k when if I is equal to j. But what are all these values a11, a22, a33 and so on, so on, an, and these are nothing but the elements of the diagonal, okay? So see here, what is the first element of the diagonal? a11. What is the second element of the diagonal? a22, a33, a44 and so on, an, okay? So these are the elements of the diagonal, but already given that here all these elements are equals to k. Therefore, trace is equal to, therefore trace of the given matrix is equal to just simply adding the all the elements of the diagonal, that is a11 plus a22 plus a33 plus and so on ann. But already given that all these values are equals to k here, that is k plus k and so on plus k n times. Here the number of k's is equal to n. Therefore, the answer is equals to n into k, and that is the first option. Okay, so this is the answer. See the next question. If a is equal to 2 minus 2 minus 4 minus 1 3 4 1 minus 2 minus 3, then what is a? So here the options are idempotent, nilpotent, involutory, orthogonal. So first I am taking the given matrix A is equal to 2 minus 2 minus 4 minus 1 3 4 1 minus 2 minus 3. Okay. And I am finding the value A square first here. A square is equal to 2 minus 2 minus 4 minus 1 3 4 1 minus 2 minus 3 into 2 minus 2 minus 4 minus 1 3 4 1 minus 2 minus 3. Now multiplying the two matrices here. So first row by the first column, that is 4 plus 2 minus 4. First row by the second column, minus 4 minus 6 plus 8. Next, first row by the third column, minus 8 plus 12. Okay. Now coming to the second row. Second row by the first column, minus 2 minus 3 plus 4. Second row by the second column, 2 plus 9 minus 8. Second row by the third column, 4 plus 12 minus 12. Now coming to the third row by the first column, 2 plus 2 minus 3. Third row by the second column, minus 2 minus 6 plus 6. Third row by the third column, minus 4 minus 8 plus 9. Okay, now this is equals to. So this value is equal to the first value 2 here, next one minus 2, next one minus 4, and this is minus 1, and this is 3, and this is 4, and this is 1, and this is minus 2, and this is minus 3. Okay, so this is nothing but a here, that is after finding the value of the a square, we will get the answer is equals to a. Therefore, the value of the A square is equal to A means the matrix A is the idempotent matrix. Idempotent matrix means what is the definition? The value of the A square is equal to A. That's all. And this is the first option. Okay, see the next question. The matrix A is equals to 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2 is. The options are unitary, orthogonal, nilpotent, involutory. So first I am taking the given matrix here A is equal to 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2. And then I am finding the value A square value. So A square is equals to A into A, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2 into minus 1 by root 2 into that matrix. Now multiplying the values, 1 by root 2 into 1 by root 2 is equals to 1 by 2, 1 by root 2 into minus 1 by root 2 is equal to 1 by 2. Now coming to this one, first row by the second value, second column, this is also equals to 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. Second row by the first column, minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. Second row by the second column, minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. Now see here, all the terms are cancelled here. So this is equal to 0, 0, 0, 0 and that is equal to 0. Therefore, the value of the A square is equal to 0 means A is said to be the nilpotent matrix. Okay, A power n is equal to 0 means the matrix A is said to be the nilpotent matrix. That's all. This is the answer. Okay, see the next question. If A is a skew symmetric matrix and n is the odd positive integer, then what is the value of the A power n? Okay, see here. What is given here? A is the skew symmetric matrix. So, I am taking one skew symmetric matrix here. This is nothing but 0, minus 1, 1, 0. Okay. So, here I take one skew symmetric matrix. What is given? N is the odd positive number. Then, what is A power n value? So, odd positive integer means again I am taking the value n is equal to 3. Okay. Now, what is the value of the A power here? So, we want the value A cube. So, A cube is equal to 0 minus 1 1 0 into 0 minus 1 1 0 into 0 minus 1 1 0. And this is equal to multiplying the values. First row by the first column is equal to minus 1. First row by the second column is equal to 0. Second row by the first column is equal to 0. Second row by the second column is equal to minus 1 into 0 minus 1 1 0. Now multiplying the two matrices here. So first row by the first column becomes 0. First row by the second column becomes 1. And second row by the first column is equal to minus 1. And second row by the second column is equal to 0. So clearly here we will get the value as the skew symmetric matrix. One checks this one. So this is the skew symmetric matrix value. Okay. Suppose I am taking that this is equal to B here. B is equal to 0, 1, minus 1, 0. Then what is B transpose value? 0, minus 1, 1, 0. And what is minus B value? 0, minus 1, 1, 0. Therefore, B transpose is equal to minus B. So the matrix B is said to be the skew symmetric. But what is B here? B is nothing but the A cube. That is the value of the A power n is the skew symmetric when here we get the value A cube is equal to symmetric matrix. Okay, that's all. That is the answer. Okay, so the next question. A is the skew symmetric matrix and n is the even positive integer. Then what is the value of the A power n? Okay, same procedure here also given that A is the skew symmetric matrix. That is here also I am taking the example of A as 0, minus 1, 1, 0. And given that n is the even positive integer, that is I am taking that here n is equal to 2 and finding the value A square. A square is equal to 0, minus 1, 1, 0 into 0, minus 1, 1, 0. Now multiplying the two matrices here, 0 into minus 1, minus 1 and 0 plus 0, 0. And this is 1 plus 0, 0 plus 0, 0. And this is minus 1. And clearly this is the symmetric matrix, not the skew symmetric matrix. What is the first condition in the skew symmetric matrix? All the elements of the diagonal are equal to 0. But here we have the diagonal as the non-zero element. So this is not the skew symmetric. Now checking the symmetric or not. So first I am taking that B is equal to A square. I am taking this A square matrix as the B here. That is B is equal to minus 1, 0, minus 1. Now finding the value of the B transpose, which returns the same value. Writing the first row as the first column and second row as the second column. Therefore, B is equal to B transpose means B is the symmetric matrix. So what is but B here? What is B here? B is equal to A square. Therefore, A square is the symmetric matrix and that is the first option. Okay. Next problem, if A comma B are two identical matrices with AB is equal to B is equal to 0, then what is the value of the A plus B? Okay, here two conditions are given. A comma B are the identical matrix. What is the meaning of the identical matrix? A square is equal to A and B square is equal to B. Given that these two matrices are the identical and also given that AB is equal to BA is equal to 0. So these four conditions are given here, but what is given question? What is A plus B? Is it scalar or idempotent or diagonal or nilpotent? So first I am taking the value A plus B whole square. Okay. So first I am finding the value A plus B whole square and taking that is A plus B into A plus B is equals to multiplying the two matrices here A into A square plus A into B AB. Okay. A into these two matrices. Now B into A, BA plus B into B, B square But already here we have that the value of the AB is equal to BA is equal to 0. So 0 plus 0 plus B square is equals to A square plus B square. That is, therefore the value of the A plus B whole square is equals to A square plus B square. But what is A square value? Already at the starting we have the condition A square is equal to A and B square is equal to B. Therefore, the answer of the A plus B whole square is equals to A plus B. That means the matrix A plus B is the idempotent matrix. Okay. What is the meaning of the A is idempotent matrix? A square is equals to A. So, here we have that A plus B whole square is equal to A plus B. That is the matrix A plus B is the idempotent matrix. Okay. That's all. Okay, see the next question. If the order of A is 4 by 3 and order of B is 4 by 5 and order of C is 7 by 3, then the order of A dash B whole dash into C dash. Okay, very easy question. Okay, see here. Given that A is the matrix of the order 4 by 3 and B is the matrix of the order 4 by 5 and C is the matrix of the order 7 by 3. Okay. So first I am finding the value A dash B. A dash B order value. That is, what is A dash order 3 by 4 and what is B order 4 by 5. Therefore, the order of A dash B is equal to 3 by 5. Okay. Now, what is question? So this is A dash B order is equal to 3 by 5, but we want the value A dash B whole dash. That is, 3 by 5 whole dash is equal to 5 by 3. Okay. Therefore, the final answer A dash B whole dash into C dash is equals to A dash B whole dash is equals to order 5 by 3 and C dash order C is equal to 7 by 3 means C dash is equal to 3 by 7. Therefore, the answer is equal to 5 by 7. Okay, that's all. Okay, now see the last question of this video. Okay, if A is equal to 3 by 4 and B is a matrix such that A dash B and B A dash are both defined, then B is of the type. We have to find the order of the matrix B here. Nothing that is given here. Only we have only two conditions, that is, the matrix A order is equal to 3 by 4 and the values A dash B and B A dash, both values are defined here. These two values are defined. This condition is given. And also given another condition, order of the A is equal to 3 by 4. By using these two conditions, we have to find the order of the vertex B. Okay, see here. A is equal to 3 by 4 means A dash is equal to 4 by 3. And also given that here, A dash B is defined. That is, A dash order is equal to 4 by 3. Then the order of the B is the 3 by something. Okay, to take the product of these two matrices, here we have to take the number of columns of the first matrix is equal to number of rows of the second matrix. That is, so clearly here we get that the first number is equal to 3. And also given that B A dash is also defined. What is B order? We don't know that value. But already here, simply I know that 3 as the first value. That is, B order 3 by something into A dash order. A dash is equals to 4 by 3. So automatically here we have to take the 4 here. Therefore, the order of B is equal to 3 by 4. That's all. This is the answer. Very simple logic. Therefore, order of the matrix is equal to 3 by 4. Okay, understand all of you?